All right. So, learning objective two is a creative collaborative response. So, there are kind of two things that you're going to be doing in this learning objective. Again, the first thing that you're going to need to do is choose a guiding question, and you can work with a partner, you can work with a group of three. I would say no more of three in a group and have diversity within your group. So, 2 7th years and an 8th year, make sure that you kind of mix up your people that you're working with and don't just choose your very best buddy. If I do see that you guys have chosen a group that isn't very diverse, I will help you choose a group that is more diverse. So, remember, this is you're trying to stretch yourself, you're trying to work with different people, diverse people. So be intentional about who you choose in your group. So you're going to be working with either a partner or a group of three, and you are going to choose a guiding question that you want to focus on as a group. And you're going to think about how you want to creatively demonstrate mastery and understanding of that guiding question. So, you do not have to all have read the same book in order to be in the same group. It's actually a little bit more meaningful if you have different books represented in your group, because then you will naturally engage in conversation about what your book was about, and you kind of become that expert on your book. But when you're thinking about then coming together and creating a collaborative, creative piece, you're going to be kind of combining the culture, the community, or themes or perspectives from these different books into one product or project. So it'll definitely take some discussion, it'll take some conversation within your group, but you're going to choose one of these guiding questions to focus on in this collaborative work. And basically, your goal is to work together to creatively demonstrate understanding of the text or text in that guiding question. Also, while you're working with a partner or in a group of three, you have to establish some responsibilities. Try to make a goal for yourself, a due date, and delegate tasks. Maybe one person's going to do this work and another person's going to do this part. Try to be as effective when it comes to communicating and clear as possible. Stay focused and on task. Manage your time wisely. Make sure you keep kind of evaluating your progress. So, how are we doing? Are we getting the work done that we wanted to get done today or not? And staying organized is an important piece. Solving problems, more than likely, a problem's gonna arise. Problems arise when you're just working individually. So when you kind of try to come together, that's gonna be a part of the process. And that's what we want you to explore and kind of work through. But again, demonstrating perseverance means that you overcome whatever that obstacle is. And if you need help problem solving, we're happy to help as well. And again, at the end of the day, when you're finished with this work, hopefully you met all of those responsibilities and goals and deadlines. And so this is your rubric. There's a lot to it because collaborating kind of takes a lot of energy and effort, but also being creative takes a lot of effort as well. And so that's why this is nice to do in a group, because you might not feel like you're as creative, or that's not a strength that you have, but it's might be a strength for other people, so you can really kind of work together on coming up with something that is engaging and creative.